Welcome back to my channel. Today we're talking about, can you get a yeast infection from sex? By the end of this video, you'll know signs and symptoms of yeast infections, answer the question, can you get a yeast infection from sexual activity? Also, can you have sex while having a yeast infection? We're gonna cover all of that and more today. Stay tuned. All right, so let's jump into our topic today. Yeast infections are so common that up to 75% of females at some point in our lifetime may have a yeast infection. You may know someone with a yeast infection, you may have had one or maybe multiple yeast infections in your lifetime, and it is not unusual. It is a very, very common situation. Let's talk about why yeast infections are so common. First off, yeast infections are not necessarily what you think of them being, like just a yeast, right? It's really a fungus. It is a fungal infection. And believe it or not, yeast is a part of us as human beings. Every young person, a child, a male, a female, it doesn't matter who you are, you have yeast on your body somewhere. You have a fungus somewhere. Now, a yeast infection happens whenever there's an overgrowth of the yeast that is present within your system. So let's kind of break it down for females, right? Because specifically when we talk about yeast infections, we're really talking about that fungal infection that is common in females, primarily in the vaginal area. If you have a yeast infection elsewhere, like in your mouth, for instance, that is called thrush. And I know you've heard of that, right? If you have a newborn baby, if you've ever breastfed, if you have any kind of like immunocompromised situations, meaning that you're sick to some degree, have been on steroids, whatever you may think of, you may have had thrush at some point. Now, there's also yeast or fungus that can affect your skin, your nails, jock itch, for instance, right? So many different things, but specifically vaginal spaces, when we have an overgrowth, we call that a yeast infection. So if you've been on my channel for a while, you've seen that we've talked about yeast infections to some degree before, so we can definitely check out a few of those videos. But what exactly happens when you're having a yeast infection and how do you feel, okay? Well, I can tell you that they are not fun at all. Yeast infections can be really annoying. They leave you feeling inflamed, swollen, you may be a little bit reddened, you may be so sensitive to touch that it may cause burning and pain. And that's with sexual activity, without sexual activity, it could be during your menstrual cycles. I mean, it's just not a fun infection to have, even though it's very, very common. And it's very easy, very, very easy to treat. We're going to talk about that as well. But these symptoms that I just mentioned are the main ones that you may be familiar with, you've heard of potentially before, and they can just cause a lot of irritation and aggravation down there. So, what causes a yeast infection? Well, this fungus is often caused by, most commonly, candida, okay? And so the infection medically is called candidiasis for a vaginal yeast infection. And so with that, the yeast that normally lives in your vagina, which is a ton, grows more than it ought to. So if we break this down to very simple terms, if you were supposed to have 100 yeast or this fungus, candida, present in the vagina at any given point, if you were to have 110 present, that's a yeast infection. 200, a yeast infection. And for sure, if you were having levels up to the thousands, that would be a yeast infection as well. So anything under what we've considered to be a normal range would be an infection. And with that, you may notice that some of those symptoms I mentioned just earlier may be present, in addition to having a lot of vaginal discharge. This discharge may be very thick, may be very clumpy, may be very watery at the same time. Essentially, you may feel like you need to wear like a pad or a tampon even just to absorb all the discharge that's happening on a daily basis. Now, with that, yeast loves moisture. So because of that, it becomes so easy for the vaginal space to create that or to have that infection because it's usually very moist down there. But there are definitely other times where you can have more moisture vaginally than you ought to, and this may increase the likelihood of you having this infection. So for instance, think of summertime. It is very hot, it's very humid outside. We may sweat a little bit more down there. You may be able to kind of connect with that, right? We sweat all the time. With that, wearing cotton underwear may be a great option for you so that you are actually decreasing the amount of sweat that is staying in the vaginal space. But if at any point you have an excessive amount of moisture from sweating, you may increase the likelihood of the yeast that is present in the vaginal space growing way more than it ought to. Think of working out. This is another very, very common practice for so many of us that if you are in very tough workout, you're sweating a lot, you're aerobically keeping your body all nice and active and you're sweating, that's normal. Sweating down there, if you leave that moisture in place for a very long time, you may have the same exact reaction where the yeast that is present normally in your vagina grows too much and causes this infection. Thirdly, sexual activity. Another way that may increase the likelihood of you having a yeast infection. This is because semen is no different from sweat or water or humidity or any other moisture that we can think of. So with that, if there is semen in the vagina and that semen lingers in that space for a very long time, and there's no real research as far as how long that might be. It could be for an hour, it could be for hours, but we don't know that. We still have work to do in the medical community, but we know that if the vaginal space has excessive moisture, even including that of semen, you may get a yeast infection. So recommendation for that for sure is please go to the restroom immediately after and try not to have like an excessive amount of semen just hanging in the vaginal space. So how do we treat yeast infections? Well, I also have another video on my channel on that, but to quickly recap here, you may actually get treatments right in your local area. You can go to any pharmacy in your area and actually look for things that end in azole, A-Z-O-L-E. Those are fungal infection treatments, and you'd want to look for one that is specific for the vaginal space. And so for instance, you may have myconazole. That's a treatment that you can get over the counter. And with this, you can insert this cream or this suppository into the vagina, usually at night, and this over a few days, anywhere between 3 and 7 days, may actually cure your yeast infection. Now, if you go to your doctor's office, which I always recommend whenever you have an infection, you'll be able to be examined, be tested, have a diagnosis that confirms a yeast infection, and then be able to get prescribed medications as well. Now, the difference between the options that you can get in the pharmacy versus a prescription at the pharmacy would be that you also have the option of taking a pill for your yeast infection treatment. And some people love that because one, you don't have to deal with the vaginal space. You don't have to insert anything if you're uncomfortable with doing that, or just the discharge that comes along with that, you can have the pill version as well. Either way, the treatment is very simple. It is highly effective, and most people within 7 to 10 days will be completely cured of this yeast infection. Most people after treatment will not have residual symptoms or problems and not necessarily have an increased likelihood of having the infection again. However, if the cause of that infection is still present, meaning that you're still staying in moist clothing or you're still having unprotected sexual activity without going to the restroom immediately after, or you're very sweaty down there and we're wearing every other underwear except for cotton, then the likelihood of you getting a yeast infection again may increase. But I also like to add in here just really quickly that even in the presence of these things that I just mentioned being very common, that's sexual activity, sweat, as well as the types of underwear that you're wearing that may increase the likelihood of having these infections. Outside of those, if you are having an infection of some other kind that you're getting treatment, like an antibiotic treatment for, you may still have an increased risk of this. Or if you have underlying medical conditions like diabetes, some hypertensive diseases, you may also be at an increased risk. So it's very important that you assess the cause of your specific problem so that you can eliminate it and not have recurrent yeast infections. So you already have the answer to the question for today's video, right? Yes, sexual activity can definitely cause a yeast infection. Now, can you have sex with a yeast infection? You can. However, it might not be the most comfortable scenario for you, okay? Because yeast infections causes a lot of irritation, and sometimes during sexual activity, your cells and your membranes and your tissues in the vagina become so inflamed that any type of touch may cause them to bleed and cause a lot of pain. So would I recommend that you have sex with a yeast infection? No. However, if you do, that's a personal choice. And if you do, one thing that I would absolutely recommend is wearing a condom or using dental dams. The reason why I recommend doing these things is that yeast infections can spread from person to person. And so that could be from female to female, female to male, male to female, or male to male. While we've done lots of research on this transmission of yeast infections from person to person, what the data shows right now is that up to 15% of males will get a yeast infection from having sex with someone with a vaginal yeast infection. So the percentage is not necessarily super high, but it's still present. And so using a condom, for instance, decreases the likelihood that your male partner will get a yeast infection as well. It is important to know that if you are to use a condom during a yeast infection, while we're taking nice safeguards here, the condom is more than likely to break due to the yeast that is present in the vaginal space as well. And so what does that mean? Well, the likelihood of having that protection you're looking for might be less. The likelihood of protecting you from pregnancy is less. The likelihood of protecting you from sexually transmitted diseases like gonorrhea or chlamydia, herpes, or even trichomonas, these are things that are, you lose that protection once your condom breaks. And so this is another reason why I would really recommend that we avoid sexual activity during a yeast infection, especially if you're getting treatment, until everything clears up, your infection is completely gone, and this has been confirmed. Yeast is actually quite powerful when we think of how they function as a species. And so with that, whenever they get in contact with the texture and the latex that is often in condoms, it can cause there to be a lot of friction. And so that condoms can break very, very easily. And so, and this is regardless of the type of condom that you're using. And especially if you were to be in the middle of treatment, the chemicals that are within the antifungal creams and medications are so powerful that they can cause that condom to not be able to do its job and to break essentially pretty easily. And so we want to be very, very cautious with that. Now, I've also mentioned this in this video, other things that we should do after sexual intercourse, in particular, going to the restroom and being sure that you clear of any semen that is hanging in your vaginal space. In addition to that, I have a few more tips before we come to a close today. And if you've been dealing with a yeast infection or would like to share with others what your experience has been like, go ahead and leave a comment in the video right below. So tip number one, go to the restroom as soon as sexual intercourse is over, and just be sure that you're not staying super moist there. Second tip would be to wear cotton underwear, because cotton is just really, really good with absorbing moisture and any other discharge that may be released from the vaginal space. My third tip is that if you feel pain, discomfort, have unusual bleeding, if you feel as though you're really inflamed or have just swelling down there after sexual activity, it is very important that you go to see the doctors. Reason being, there's so many different causes of infections in the vagina, and yeast, yes, is a very common one, but we also want to make sure that there isn't something else underlying that's going on, that you actually need a different type of treatment. such as antibiotics, or you might not need a treatment at all. It's just a matter of giving your vagina time to replenish itself. So doctors will help with that. So definitely go and see your doctor if necessary. So I'm excited that you've been here with us today. And there's so much more on my channel about these types of infections, as well as other ways that as people, we're able to enhance our bodies. And so with that, I have a special free gift for you below. Hormones Don't Lie. This is where we really dive into the hormones that make us who we are and affects things like down there in the vaginal space, like yeast infections. And so if you would like to get a copy of that, click the link below to my website and follow the prompts, and I'll be more than happy to share that with you. I'm Dr. Perkins, a board certified OBGYN, and it's my pleasure to have these discussions with you. Stay tuned and join us for so many more as we talk about treatments, problems, and ways to enhance our bodies as females. Thanks for being here.